Hello, everybody. Good evening and welcome into the magnificent Mabee Center on the campus of Oral Roberts University. The 52nd annual Tournament of Champions continues here, day number one, session two, and we got a great game ahead of us. It's the Battle of the Chargers between the number seven ranked team in Class 4A, Heritage Hall, and the number two ranked team out of Class 5A, the undefeated Memorial Chargers, 9-0 on the season. Heritage Hall ranked number seven and 2-1 on the year. Heritage Hall, though, has not played a game since December 8th. Michael Knight courtside here at the Mabee Center alongside Rod Thompson. And Rod, first off, thanks for coming out for a great afternoon, great evening of high school basketball here in Oklahoma. And we got a great matchup on deck.
Well, it should be very good when you talk about two very good teams, that both teams having a chance to win a state championship in their class. I think you look at Heritage Hall, a lot of talent on the floor, team that played well together for many years, some exciting junior and seniors. And then when you look at Memorial, Coach Bobby Allis has done a tremendous job. He is loaded over there. Yeah. Outstanding players. It has great size, great shooting. He has those guys playing unselfish. And so, I mean, I think, you know, Memorial definitely the clear-cut favorite if you looked on paper, but some outstanding players they have.
Let's take a look at the starting lineups first for the Memorial Chargers. Again, ranked number two in Class 5A, only behind number one Carl Albert, who they fell to in a classic of a championship game last year. 9-0 on the season. Their head coach is Bobby Allison. Starting with Caleb Nero, you have to start there. 6'2 senior, averaging 25 points per game. He really makes this team go. Shamar Walker, don't overlook him at the guard position, although it's easy to overlook him at 5'7", just a junior. He's averaging 6.7 points a game. Kalen Childs, a 6'4 senior, averages 5 points a game. Kobe Rose, the big man for Memorial, 6'3 senior, averaging nearly 17 points a game. And then you got the big man, Isaiah Thomas. Not that Isaiah Thomas. This is the football Army All-American Isaiah Thomas, averaging a double-double, 11 points per game and 10 rebounds. There you see the Heritage Hall Chargers starting lineup on your screen. John Matthews, Les Thomas, William McDonald, Savon Milton, and Sam Kakish. For Heritage Hall, their head coach is Chris Hamilton. And you mentioned it, Rod, Heritage Hall, a team moving up from 3A. They made it. They won the 3A state title a few years ago. They made it to the 3A title game last year. And now they're moving up to Class 4A this year. And so far, yeah, they beat Cache Hall. They beat Mount St. Mary's. Then they lose earlier this month to Douglas. But they haven't played since December 8th. Does that have any effect on this team as they get out and get ready to play a Memorial team that's definitely battle-tested, playing nine games already this year?
Well, I think a couple things you look at. This atmosphere is a little different when you talk about the Tournament of Champions playing here at ORU. For them, it's going to be what they did during that break. Did they have some scrimmages set up? If they didn't play it, it will be an adjustment. But I think looking at this team, they have a lot of experience, are used to playing guys who are tried doing the AAU summer circuit. So they're used to playing. Yeah. But Memorial right now, definitely playing at a high level. Coach Bobby Allison has his team playing well. You know, and you talked about in the starting lineup, you talked about two X factors. I think, you know, Caleb Nero is an outstanding player. He's going to get it done, him and Kobe Rose. But when you look at Shamar Walker and Isaiah Thomas, two guys that understand their roles, do a tremendous job, one of the main reasons this team has a chance to go on and win it all.
Memorial, this is where the TOC started, at Memorial High School, and this is their 35th appearance in the Tournament of Champions. That is the most all time. They appeared in the first 24 TOCs as Memorial will win the opening tap. Their last appearance came 2 years ago. They won a triple overtime thriller over Owosso, as that was AJ Cockrell and company. And by the way, Caleb Nero had a coming out party in that championship game, knocked down several threes as the Chargers controlled the opening tap. They're on offense, moving left to right here in the first half in the home white uniforms. Red Memorial across the front, trimmed in blue. Shamar Walker with the basketball in between the two circles. Bounce pass to Rose. Rose underneath to Thomas. Thomas just muscling Sam Kanish to the ground.
And you can kind of see the game plan now, you know, with Thomas inside. And this is what you're going to see with Memorial. There's not going to be too many teams. Any clash is going to be as big as they are. So they're trying to take advantage of their size inside.
Inbound pass to Childs. Childs, little turnaround on the baseline. Can't get it to fall. Matthews controls the rebound and will control the point
And John Matthews, he'll put a lot of pressure on the defense. Really gets downhill offensively. Can really create and get in the lane. Also hit the mid-range jump shot.
Matthews working on Walker. Gets it to Les Thomas. Thomas can't get the jumper. Oh, I spoke too soon. Thought that was going to rattle off, but it fell for Thomas, who has the first basket of tonight's game. Heritage Hall leading early, 2-0. Kobe Rose.
And Les Thomas, he can definitely score in bunches. Knock down the outside shot. That's a tough assignment guarding Nero.
Underneath to Thomas. That's a mismatch that Memorial probably wants to take advantage of as the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Savon Milton. No, they're going to say Memorial touched it. And Milton and Kobe Rose exchanging pleasantries, I'm sure. How you doing? How was your Christmas?
Yeah,
I'm sure that was part of the conversation. And I mentioned it earlier, Isaiah Thomas from Memorial, an Army All-American on the football field. And I joked with Bobby Allison beforehand. I said, Coach, if he was an Under Armour All-American, you wouldn't have him tonight. He'd be in Orlando. But Isaiah going to take off for San Antonio after the tournament is over and play in that All-American game next Saturday.
No doubt. I'm definitely going to miss him, but it's great talent. You see they're going to try to pound it inside. And this is where Matthews, John, has to be careful. They have to have him on the court that time getting that drawing the foul with the help down.
Yeah. He's going to get whistled for the foul. 2-0. Score, Heritage Hall on top. Memorial yet to get anything really going offensively. We'll see if Kobe Rose can change that. The 3 too strong. Thomas comes up with the board. He wants to run it. By the way, I mentioned it. Memorial in their 35th TOC all-time. Heritage Hall making their first appearance ever in school history at the Tournament of Champions. Caleb Nero to Shamar Walker. Walker drives all the way to the basket, kisses it off the glass,
and that's what he does. Right back defensively, doing a good job locating Matthews. And he is an X factor. Outstanding young man, has leadership qualities, and you've seen him continue to work. That's why he's in this starting lineup with Coach Bobby Allison.
Absolutely. Matthews thought about that 3. Gets it back now. Into the corner to Milton. Milton working on a defender. Back to Matthews. He wants a 3 this time. Left it short. Rebound being fought for. Won by Memorial momentarily. Kobe Rose, a good hustle play, but just could not get there in time. Les Thomas also attributed to it as he tipped it all the way into the backcourt. It'll go back to Heritage Hall.
And in order for Heritage Hall to come away with this win, they have to knock down some outside shots. The size advantage is just too tough down inside. See, Memorial, they'll switch it up, go to a little zone defense, a little matchup zone. Now back to man. Look for Matthews. He got to get some penetration, get in the lane, and locate his shooters.
Matthews found an opening but used an illegal screen to do it. Sam Kanish going to get whistled for the foul.
Yeah, just waited a little too long to come off that screen.
As Clayton Graff going to come into the game. Kanish will sit down. We'll see if Graff has any more luck going up against Isaiah Thomas on the block. Shamar Walker, bounce pass to Rose. Nero on the left wing. He wants to take it all the way to the rim. He leaves the floater short, and we're going to have a foul on Memorial. Kobe Rose with the illegal screen. John Matthews and Heritage Hall, the designated road team here this afternoon. This evening, I should say. Navy blue uniforms. Golden Heritage across the front. Of course, if you're familiar with OKPreps.com, and we definitely hope you are, you've seen plenty of Heritage Hall over the last few years. This Heritage Hall, one of many network schools that stream their games, football, basketball, baseball, all sporting events, live on OKPreps.com. Chargers turn it over here in Memorial. Going to get an extra possession. Childs with it. Also into the game, just checked in. Corey Guest for the Chargers. Shamar Walker.
Corey Guest, long rangey sophomore, and Childs can make this outside shot. Didn't come close on that one, but he is another guy that can get it going for Memorial. So many weapons.
A little too much on that 3. Heritage Hall back into the front court. Matthews, you can tell his game is just give me a little bit of space.
Yeah.
That's all I need. If you give me some space, I'm going to make you pay. Very methodical in his game. Is quick off the dribble. Nice pass. Shot too strong, and it's going to go out of bounds. And it'll go over to the Chargers. Kobe Rose going to come back into the game. He only had about, I'd say 30, 45 seconds of rest. But that's all you need for a senior who's averaging over 16 points a game. Heritage Hall coming out with a little full court pressure. And they force a turnover. The Chargers from Oklahoma City going the other way. Second chance opportunity. Thomas going to launch for three. Leaves that one well short and goes out of bounds.
And good contest by Guess. Right there using his range. And boy, we got ourselves a shootout right here, don't we?
Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking. Matthews off the turnover. Both teams not exactly playing clean basketball in the early going, as both teams struggling from the field, both teams turning the ball over. You would think that both of these teams haven't played since early December.
Nice.
Here's
pass.
Thomas can't finish underneath, but he'll go to the free throw line to shoot two. Rod, we're 5 minutes into this game. We only got four combined points. This is a Memorial team that's averaging 80 points a game. They put up 113 points back on December 6th.
We could really score in bunches, but boy, right now. And look for Caleb Nero. He can get going, can score a lot of points in a hurry. I need to try to get him going also, but said both teams a little tight right now. The biggest thing is, you know, neither team has got any transition baskets. You want to try to get some stuff in transition, but both teams have done a good job of securing, you know, in transition defense. So get to that free throw line, get some easy basket, quick hitters right here, maybe to the basket.
Thomas can't convert on either free throw. That's Les Thomas back the other way. He misses that shot, and Isaiah trying to get it to Caleb Nero, throws it away. Another turnover goes back to Heritage Hall as Kalen Childs will check back in for Memorial. Isaiah will sit down. Also into the game for the first time is a 6'7 sophomore that Bobby Allison cannot stop talking to me about, and Caleb Boone. It seems like every single conversation I have with him, he brings up his 6'7 sophomore.
Yeah, and he's going to be an outstanding player for Coach Allison. You know, the main thing about him, unbelievable attitude. Works hard, has a great attitude.
We're going to have a
lot of illegal screens right here, but you talk about Boone offensively. He can really score. He's long, he's rangy, can also block shots. And, you know, when you find players inside that can impact the game without scoring points, then you're way ahead of the game. And that's what this young man can do. He works hard. You know, when Coach Allison calls on him, he's ready to go, going to be an outstanding player.
Look, anytime your coach says, if he, you know, grows into his potential, he could be as good as Caleb Green, that's pretty good. Caleb Nero trying to get going here, and he gets that little floater to go.
Yeah, very crafty. Can get in the lane and finish. You see him, his change of direction, change of speed, very good. And able to get up and elevate and finish.
Heritage Hall looking for a response here. Closing in on 2 minutes left in the first quarter. And that's not a typo on the scoreboard. It is 4-2 in favor of the Memorial Chargers from Tulsa. Ball goes out of bounds. Last touch says that was Rajon Davis trying to save that one from going out of bounds. Corey Guest set to trigger the inbound pass to Caleb Nero.
And right now you see, as we said earlier, if Heritage Hall can't knock down outside shots, it's going to be tough.
Winner of this game gets Edmond North tomorrow in the semifinals. That'll be a fun one, as Edmond North, they ran away from Fort Cobb-Broxton in a game earlier today. Nero with a little floater on the baseline. Left that one short. There's Matthews again. He comes up with a rebound. He wants to go coast to coast. This time he pulls up, knocks down the jumper.
And that's what he can do. Matthews can get going in a hurry.
Quickly back into the front court come the Memorial Chargers. Guest thought about that three. Instead puts it on the floor. Spin move, little jumper, can't get it. Heritage Hall with the board. Up ahead to John Matthews. Matthew surveying the defense, finds a wide open Les Thomas who can't get the three to fall. Kobe Rose wants to run. Puts the brakes on, now gets it to Guest. Guest, a little hook pass intended for Caleb Boone. Turned over to the Chargers of Heritage Hall. Thomas thought about that three, this time going to drive. Wide open man in the corner. Here's a floater, baseline off the glass, too strong.
Boy, just can't buy a basket. They're getting open looks. Just can't buy one right now.
45 seconds left in the first quarter. Looking forward to getting some of those, the stat numbers from our stat guy here at the TOC to see the shooting percentage for both teams. Both of them struggling as Kalen Childs makes that shot. His first. Memorial now leads at 6-4. Last shot. Opportunity potentially for Heritage Hall. If they want it, they'll take it. John Matthews working on Caleb Nero. Blows right past him. Little up and under layup. Can't get it with the left hand. Nero up ahead. Blows right past the defender. Runs over Les Thomas in the process. And kisses that one off the glass and in. Heritage Hall, before the first quarter buzzer sounds, it's off the mark. And we've reached the end of one. Memorial leading Heritage Hall 8-4. Caleb Nero with that basket right before the first quarter buzzer. The Heritage Hall coaches were upset. They thought Les Thomas was set underneath the basket for a charge. What did you see?
Well, I think that was a close play right there. I thought Nero did a good job of kind of rotating over and sliding and not allowing Thomas to be square on that call. I thought it was a good no call. But, boy, Heritage Hall, just the easy lift. They're getting the looks they want. John Matthews can really create off the dribble and get guys open looks and open shots. They're just not able to knock them down. And they got to do a good job, you know, defensively with Nero. He can get going, getting in the lane and create. The refs are letting them play. And so it's going to be interesting to see in this second quarter. You know, it hasn't been the advantage of the size so far offensively for Memorial. You know, they haven't been able to pound inside have that be an advantage, but the difference has been just defensively, Heritage Hall not able to make shots.
Yeah, and we got the numbers to back it up. 2 of 13 from the field, 15% Heritage Hall shooting there in the first quarter. 0 for 5 from three-point land. Memorial, not much better, a little better, not much though. 44% from the field, 4 of 9. They shot the three ball twice, missed both opportunities as Memorial leading Heritage Hall 8-4 here after one quarter. Second quarter action beginning now. Michael Knight alongside Rod Thompson here courtside at the Mabey Center on the campus of Oral Roberts University. 52nd annual Tournament of Champions. Matthews wants three, leaves this one short. Boy, Kobe Rose comes up with the board.
He still can't get anything to go, and boy, he can make those shots. This is where you got to locate Nero, especially in transition. He likes to get to that left hand.
Nero passes it off. Now Walker has it for the Chargers. Here's Rose, open for three, knocks it down.
And Kobe Rose going to Connor State, lefty. He can make shots and get to the basket. Kind of a danger zone right now for Heritage Hall.
Definitely don't want to give Memorial any more momentum. There's a good response that time. Yes. From Savon Milton.
Savon Milton, he's the most athletic guy, big-time track guy. He can really get going in a hurry, and so can Rose. Kobe Rose that with was, another three.
Yeah, 6 points now quickly for Kobe Rose. 14-6, Memorial on top. Speaking of Connor State, Bobby Allison told me that former Memorial standout A.J. Cockrell, as Savon Milton answers with a three of his own, A.J. Cockrell going to transfer from Texas San Antonio to Connor State.
Yeah, he definitely is. He's going to be a key piece. Connor State loading him up. Memorial Central.
As Rose can't get that one to fall. Kobe Rose and Savon Milton. A little back and forth baskets here in the early going of the second quarter. Rose will shoot free throws. The lefty launches. Gets that one to go. 7 points for Rose. Fifteen to nine in favor of Memorial. Memorial 9-0 on the year. They've beaten teams like East Central, Ardmore, Webster.
Booker T.
Oklahoma City Storm, a couple out-of-state teams as well. They've won all their games by at least 10 points. Average winning margin of 23 points per game. That's pretty stout.
Yeah, very good team, well coached. And those are the shots. You can get a couple of those down. It's going to make the defensive Memorial change a little bit.
First basket for him. Kobe Rose leaves that three ball short. Big Isaiah Thomas gets the rebound. Can't get the putback, but Kobe Rose right there, and he's coming alive with 10 points.
Yeah,
all of them in the second.
And you see how active he is. He can get on the roll. They're going to keep the ball out of John Matthews' hands.
Here's a wide open Milton trying to answer with a three. Get it.
Yeah, and he can get on the roll also. So now some shots starting to fall. You see a little zone now.
Caleb Nero. There's the guy. You want the ball in his hands. Rose. Nice dish on the baseline drive to Isaiah Thomas.
Yeah, and that's why Isaiah Thomas is, I mean, he can finish around the basket. He's a big guy who eats up a lot of space. So it makes a huge difference when you have somebody like him to anchor inside. He brings that football toughness that he brings, outstanding size. You take him out of the middle, it makes a big difference. But very unselfish. And I say this all the time about very good teams, and been fortunate to do this a long time. You see the very good teams. Memorial, when you talk about matching up and the players that they have, unbelievable players. But Coach Bobby Allison has done a good job of getting everybody to buy in. He told me, he said, Rod, we're very, very good when Caleb Nero and Kobe Rose, my two best players, make everybody else better. Yeah. And he's done a good job so far of everybody buying in. You don't see guys hunting for shots or trying to get, you know, my money and all this. And because of that, it's translated to a very good team. And a lot of credit to Coach Allison, because in today's time with kids and parents, that's hard to do.
Absolutely.
Very hard to do.
Out of the Memorial timeout, that was a 30-second timeout for the Chargers. Heritage Hall with the basketball. John Matthews with the ball. He gets it to Milton, who's been red hot. And now we're going to get a foul as a little late. Late on the whistle, but there was contact. Only the second team foul on Memorial. 16 fouls for Heritage Hall. So Memorial, look, they haven't played a completely clean game. They've turned the ball over a bunch, but foul-wise, they're keeping it pretty clean. Here's an open three for Milton. He's not going to miss many more of those. The Chargers back into the front court. Caleb Nero wants an open three. Leaves that one short. Rebound tipped to the wrong guy as Will McDonald tips that one to Kalen Childs, who finishes.
And there's that size again that you talk about with Childs.
McDonald, he could only put one hand on it and just tipped it in hopes of. Only problem was he tipped it to the wrong guy. And Heritage Hall with another turnover. It'll go back to Memorial. And you just kind of get the feeling watching this part of the second quarter. And look, you just kind of forget about the first. That both teams, you know, it is what it is. They've forgotten about it. So can we. But and Kobe Rowe is going to get called for the travel that Chris Webber didn't get called for back in the 93 title game. Just kind of picked up that pivot step and went on to go with it. This time it's called. 4:22 left in the second quarter. That was the exact same move. John Matthews running the point. Heritage Hall, important possession here. Just feel like all the momentum is on Memorial's side right now. Milton keeping it close here in the second quarter. Here's a pass to Thomas. He needs to get going. Can't get that one to fall. Boone with the rebound. Back to Rose.
And that's the twin brother. A lot of Boones.
Shot from Childs. And there's only so many times we can bring up the size mismatch.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it is.
Well, and the key is they're taking advantage of it.
Yeah.
You know, understand the game plan and taking advantage of it Definitely key.
That shot from Milton.
Good pass.
Way off. Rose to Nero. Count it.
That's a great play by Rose right there. Finally, and that's what you're talking about. That kind of teamwork right there, playing together, seeing each other. Huge.
I mean, yeah, Rose probably could have taken it himself and been just as successful, but this way he gets the assist, and Nero the free throw line.
Kobe Rose finishing that layup was a good play. Him passing Nero was a better play.
Yep.
And that makes a huge difference when you look for each other.
Caleb Nero, there you see him, 6'2 senior. Been doing this for a while with Memorial.
Yes, he has. Very good player, and he's going to get some more opportunities college-wise. Hasn't committed anywhere yet, but he's going to get some opportunities. And a lot of these kids we talking about, and I've been fortunate enough to be around them a lot. Very good kids.
Milton going to get fouled going up. Take your pick, either Walker or Thomas. I believe they're going to get Walker with the foul. 3:17 left in the second quarter. Memorial, they're getting closer and closer to breaking this one open. And I'll tell you what, at the end of the first quarter, if you would have told me that about 4 minutes in, we'd be talking about a blowout, I would have said you're crazy. Both teams struggling mightily in the first quarter. But Memorial flipping the switch, so to speak. As Milton standing at the free throw line. Made the first. He's got 9. 6'3 senior. Makes the second free throw. Give him double figures with 10 points to lead Heritage Hall. He matches Kobe Rose for the game high of 10 points. Nero to Childs. Back to him. Senior underneath to Thomas. And he could have slammed it. Big man. Let me call it for you. The left hand is over the rim.
And that's a nice play by Caleb Nero. Getting in the lane. He likes to get into that left. But finding his open teammate makes a big difference. You know, easy shots. And you see Heritage taking a little more, ill-advised shot.
Nero all the way to the basket.
Good shot, Caleb Nero. He can get on the roll.
Well, here what you're seeing is Heritage Hall, they're settling for jumpers.
Yep.
That was a good play right there.
Yeah. Got it to the high post in the teeth of that zone defense and was able to knock it down. But Memorial going to shoot a better percentage because their shots are so much easier. Name of the game.
Heritage Hall this time takes a 30-second timeout. 2:27 left in the second quarter gives us an opportunity to remind you to follow us on Twitter at OKPrepsTV. For up-to-the-minute news on everything going on in high school sports, you can follow OK Preps on Twitter. And we also want to hear from you if you're watching us now on OKPreps.com. And we thank you for doing so. But tweet us where you're watching from. It's the 52nd Annual Tournament of Champions. And that's one of my favorite parts of this tournament is hearing from where people are watching. Last year, we had people watching in from Hawaii, which – spend some time on the beach. I don't know why you're watching high school. Must be a hoops junkie if you're watching some high school basketball in Oklahoma from Hawaii, but obviously some family involved there. Also had people tuning in from New York City, so we want to hear from you. Tweet at us at OKPrepsTV. Memorial out of the timeout. Nero going to attack the paint once again. Can't get that one to fall, but it'll go back to the free throw line. To shoot two. Michael Knight alongside Rod Thompson here, courtside at the Mabee Center on the campus of Oral Roberts University. Nero set to shoot two free throws. First free throw is good. Memorial hoping that this is the first of two trips to the Mabee Center this season, as of course the 5A and 6A state tournaments held traditionally here at ORU's Mabee Center. They made it all the way to the title game. And I'll tell you what, if you're Memorial, I don't know if you want Carl Albert or if you just don't want anything to do with the Titans at this point, as Carl Albert has eliminated Memorial the last 2 years on buzzer beaters in the state tournament. 2 years ago in the semifinals, last year in the championship game.
Yeah, well, I think, we talk about Carl Albert, Trey Hopkins, and what he's able to do offensively, but I think right now, and seeing both teams this time in the season, you give the edge to Memorial.
Very slight.
Very slight.
Slight.
The size advantage with Trey Hopkins and Mason Earl is such tough matchups, as we saw, you know, epic battle. You never know what happens in the, you know, come playoffs. But, I mean, those two teams and that state championship game was – definitely unbelievable, instant yes. classic.
Oh, yeah.
With Trey Hopkins getting the tip in for the game winner in the state championship.
How about the young talent in the Mid-Dell area? Carl Albert, couple juniors, and Mason Harrell and Trey Hopkins. And then Midwest City, we saw them earlier today with a pair of juniors of their own, Keyshawn Embry and Jalen Redmond. They got a lot of good basketball on the way in the Mid-Dell area.
Very good. And I was fortunate enough to coach those guys this summer, and so you get to see them play on a national level, and boy, we got some outstanding talent here. You can't leave Nero open right there. He's going to usually knock that shot down. But there's that size advantage.
Isaiah Thomas with the basket. Here's the open jumper. Again, Memorial settling for these fast jump shots. Now, that wasn't that bad of a look, but still, it's just kind of the sentiment here is Kobe Rose going to get called for the charge.
Yeah, and you see now the, you know, Heritage is kind of, this is not their tempo that they want to play. They're kind of out of their element right now. Have to settle down and try to get some shots in transition.
Heritage Hall trailing Memorial 35-18. Last time Heritage Hall was on the floor was back on December 8th. And we had that game on OKPreps.com. They lost in a battle of 4A top 5 versus 3A top 5 to Douglas, 71-57. A rare loss for Heritage Hall at home. That was the last time they were on the floor. And Thomas, ill-advised pass, stolen by Milton. And Milton going to get free throws as Thomas hacks him on the way up.
You see Milton showing his athleticism right there on the steal and going up with the left hand. Try to cut this lead going into the half, knock down these free throws and get it to 15 range.
Free throw is good. Milton remains perfect at the charity stripe, 3 for 3, 13 points for Milton on the evening. Leads all scorers. Caleb Nero has 11 from Memorial. Kobe Rose with 10. Second free throw up and in for Savon Milton. Walker to Nero. 40 seconds left in the first half. Nero passes Thomas, and we're going to get another somewhat late call as Nero was passed. He already got past Les Thomas, and then we got the whistle as Thomas is called for the block. Nero will go to the free throw line to shoot a 1-1. 3 for 3 from the charity stripe so far. 35 seconds left. Memorial. All Chargers from Tulsa, that is, in this one. Here in the second quarter, it was 8-4, if you can believe that, at the end of the first quarter.
They must have heard us talking about them and kind of got on the roll there.
Nero made the first. And he makes the second. Left. Thomas.
And they've done a good job of really extending that zone defensively. See if they can get it at the high post. Make that defense collapse.
Thomas into the corner. 20 seconds left. Here's Thomas. Had an opportunity to call his name a whole lot. Three balls short. Another opportunity for Heritage Hall. Milton can't get that one to fall. 3 seconds. Memorial, they're probably not going to get off a shot here, and we're going to get a travel call right before the second quarter comes to a close, and we're just going to call it good, which is the right call. 37-20 is the score at the half. And I tell you, again, so impressed with what Memorial was able to do there in the second quarter. When you consider the struggles that both teams had in the first quarter, what the Chargers from Tulsa were able to do there in the second period, very impressive.
Well, I think you talk about executing the game plan. Really settled in after that slow start. Start pounding the ball inside, and then you see them tighten down defensively. Coach Allison goes to a zone, really extends it, and really gave Heritage Hall trouble. They got some buckets in transition. Nero done a tremendous job of getting into the lane, making plays, rolls, knocking down shots. Made a huge difference in that second quarter. Thus, they have the run, but really the game plan, taking advantage of their size, made a huge difference.
Outscore Heritage Hall 29-16 in the second quarter to take a 17-point advantage into the halftime break. And how about this stat for you? You talk about the size difference. Well, that shows up in the stat sheet with points in the paint. They outscored Heritage Hall in the paint 20-2. That's pretty impressive. Memorial shooting 14-23 from the field. Heritage Hall not so good. 7 of 30, 2 for 15 from beyond the three-point arc. And again, I bring up something that I started noticing there in the second quarter. Heritage Hall just settling for some jump shot after jump shot. Savon Milton, he started to get going a little bit. He leads all scorers with 14. Caleb Nero has 13 for Memorial. Kobe Rose, a fast start to that second quarter with 10 points and 8 rebounds. And when you look at some of the other numbers, 10 turnovers from Memorial, but it hasn't really hurt him, as Heritage Hall has only been able to get 2 points off of those turnovers. 23 rebounds for Memorial compared to just 10 for Heritage Hall. We can say it once, we can say it 1,000 times. This matchup is all about the size. And Memorial has proven that they're taking advantage of it with a tremendous showing there in the second quarter, 37-20 Chargers on top of Heritage Hall. Again, the winner of this game moves on to tomorrow's semifinal, as Edmond North beat Fort Cobb Broxton earlier this afternoon. And the winner will move on to face Edmond North. The loser will face Fort Cobb Broxton in consolation play. Before we take a timeout, before we get to the second half, your thoughts on the other boys matchup in the first round, as Union will take on Tahlequah Sequoia. Union, a team used to being here at the Tournament of Champions, but at the same time, this is a Union team that they've had a little slow start out of the gate. They haven't been as impressive as a lot of people thought.
Yeah, and I think when you look at Union, they're definitely going to be one of the biggest, you know, schools in any class when you talk about having Ethan Shaguar and Adrian Rodriguez.
Yeah.
So you got those two guys at that size, both Division I players. I think, you know, the guard play has really had to get better for, you know, Union so far. I think they kind of struggled in that area. But Coach Garcia, he'll get those guys going. Be interested to see how they play tonight. Tahlequah Sequoia is going to be a team that plays with a lot of energy, going to be all over the place, you know, really going to try to push the ball. Again, it's going to be size versus speed. And so it's going to be interesting. And then when you talk about, you know, Edmond North, Coach Terry Evans has done a tremendous job with that team. They're playing extremely well, you know, and they're loaded.
He hasn't lost a game in the regular season. The only game that Terry Evans has lost at Edmond North is right here on this floor in the 6A semifinals last year.
Yeah, and it's making a huge difference. He does a tremendous job coaching those young men. He has some outstanding talent. They're another team that, you know, if Memorial can keep playing like they're playing right now and come away with this win, got a lot of game left. But if they can, that will be an epic matchup tomorrow. I wonder what time that matchup is tomorrow. But it's going to be a very, very good game if Heritage Hall can't make a run here.
And that semifinal matchup will be between Edmond North and the winner of this game will be at 4 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. The winner of the Union Tahlequah Sequoia game will play Midwest City tomorrow evening at 7 o'clock. Midwest City beating Central earlier today. Big game from Keyshawn Embry, 30-plus points in the win. Jalen Redmond, another strong performance, as Jalen Redmond had a coming-out party in the TOC last year. And while watching him play in this tournament a year ago, I thought to myself, that is a linebacker playing basketball. And he ends up playing football for the very first time varsity-wise this year. What does he do? He makes the OKPreps.com All-State first team. 14 sacks on the season.
Yeah, and about five or six Division I offers.
He's a freak.
Oh, he definitely is. I mean, fortunate enough to be able to coach him during the summer, and just his competitive nature and how hard he competes. And with his size and athleticism, to have him, you know, you see him out here on the court and it's a loose ball. Well, if he's close to it, you know who's going to get it.
Yeah.
Jalen Redmond. Then you talk about Keyshawn Embry. I mean, just a tremendous talent, only a junior. As you said today, 33 points, 14 rebounds. And you know, just to talk about his performance, you know, the one thing I say about him is that, you know, everybody wants to be so positional now in this game. You know, yeah. I'm a one, I'm a two. And we saw today him playing a very good game against Central with, you know, you talk about Elijah Landrum, you know, SMU signee who's who had 30 in that game. He's an outstanding player. When you talk about Emory, though, the thing that he done, you know, he scored from every facet of the game. He saw mismatch, and you saw him go to the post and post up. And, you know, he probably got 12, 13 points in the post. A lot of kids wouldn't do that. They wouldn't be classified, well, I'm a big guy. I think, you know, him just being able to have those matchups, understand that matchup, has made him a very good player and a big-time recruit that a lot of schools all over the country are wanting his services right now.
We're going to step aside when we come back. We'll have third quarter basketball as Heritage Hall back on the floor warming up for the second half. They trail Memorial here at halftime. 37-20 is our score. Memorial on top. Second half about to be underway here. Michael Knight, Rod Thompson, courtside here at the Mabee Center on the campus of Oral Roberts University. Memorial will have the ball to start the third quarter as we flip the switch as the Chargers of Memorial moving right to left here. Shamar Walker driving baseline. Pass going out of bounds. Last touch by Heritage Hall. Walker will inbound the ball underneath his own basket. Actually, they're going to call a foul on Heritage Hall, blocking foul on Heritage. And Isaiah Thomas, nice touch from the big man.
Yeah, nice move right there by Thomas. Did a good job of really selling that fake to Nero and tacking the basket and finishing with the left hand. Outstanding job by him.
Les Thomas, right wing. Back to John Matthews. Quiet first half from both of those guys. Matthews, quick move, got a little space, took advantage of it.
And that's what he can do. He's so shifty, can change directions, and didn't shoot the ball well in that first half, but can really shoot the outside shot.
Ball going back to Heritage Hall. If John Matthews can get going here, look, it's 39-22. Memorial, they've really been in control since the second quarter early on. But if Matthews, here's a three, if he starts heating up.
And that's what he can do. He can get going in a hurry.
Heritage Hall definitely not going to go away anytime soon. Memorial beats the full court pressure. Nero all the way to the basket. Can't get that one to fall, but he'll go to the free throw line to shoot two. Nero with 13 points. A perfect 5-for-5 from the charity stripe. Makes the first free throw. Second free throw, in and out. Heritage Hall with a rebound. Matthews crossing half court, working on Kobe Rose. Now a double team. Matthews gives it off to a teammate. Here's a three ball left, short rebound. 1-4 by Memorial. Nero up ahead. And Caleb gonna pull things up. Gets it to Shamar Walker. Underneath to Isaiah Thomas. The ball will go out of bounds. Last touched by Heritage Hall. It'll remain Charger basketball for the Tulsa Memorial Chargers. Walker throws it all the way up to Thomas.
And that's what you talk about right there with, you know, Thomas. Nobody about like Redman. Nobody was going to get that ball but him.
Walker drives baseline. The littlest man on the floor nearly making a play. Can't get that baseline layup to fall, though. John Matthews quickly into the front court. Traveled with it. Baseline referee saw that.
And he can get going in a hurry, but that time.
It was such a fast move that you almost didn't see the travel.
Yeah.
Childs to Rose to Walker. Walker with a little pull-up Jay knocks it down.
I love the way Walker plays. He's done a tremendous job for Coach Bobby Allison. Weighed his turn, just worked his way into the starting lineup, and boy, just a leader out there on the court, picking and choosing his spots, but really being the general and leading his team. And the one thing it's allowed Coach Allison to do is to take Caleb Nero, who can really score the ball, off the ball.
Yeah.
You know, and allow him to not be as winded offensively. And thus, I think you're going to see the production, Nero scoring, go up, and all because of Shamar.
He's averaging 25 points per game already. Thomas misses the front end of these free throws. Nero here this evening with 14 points already, tying Savon Milton for the game high. Thomas, second free throw. Hit the front iron, but it got the friendly roll. Nero walking it up to half court. Nice pass to Childs. Childs drives baseline, runs over a Heritage Hall defender. But he's going to get whistled for the foul. That was William Dunn. No, check that. Les Thomas actually gets called for the foul. It's his third personal.
I didn't think Thomas was close that time.
Well, that's what the scoreboard here has, and that's what the PA guy just announced. But I thought it was William Dunn, but all right.
Can we go to the replay?
No, you know what? I check that. It was Will McDonald. I mixed up names. Will McDonald. Both free throws missed from Childs. Matthews with the basketball. So quick.
Yes, he is.
Doesn't matter which hand. Thomas crossing over his defender, driving baseline, and running into a steel curtain in Isaiah Thomas. you drive baseline, you go into the paint, and you meet Isaiah Thomas. I don't know who would win that one-on-one battle. Maybe a Jalen Redmond. I'd love to see it. Sign me up for that. As Thomas ran in. Les Thomas, I should say, ran into Isaiah down low and just kind of bounced right off of him. Isaiah didn't even move. Les makes both free throws, though.
Thomas trying to get him going, trying to get over the hump. They got to get some stuff done defensively.
And Les had an extremely quiet first half. Made a couple free throws here in the third quarter. If he gets going, Heritage Hall can get back into this thing. But they got to get some stops defensively. And one way you do that is by rebounding the ball. And so far on this possession, they haven't had success. Memorial, several offensive rebounds.
And they just can't get it going when it comes to the rebounding.
Shamar Walker set to trigger the inbound pass underneath his own basket. Again, the winner of this game moves on to the Tournament of Champions semifinal round as John Matthews. He doesn't come down with the pass, but he pretty much stole that away.
He's so active.
Save on Milton. Nice move on the baseline, but he gets whistled for the travel.
Talk about Matthews. He's so active defensively also.
Caleb Nero up across half court. Going to give it off to Rose. Rose back to Nero. He had some space for a moment. Now they'll find a wide open Rose on the baseline. Kobe going to reset things. Now to Caleb. Nero attacking. We're going to get a blocking call underneath the basket. This time, I know for sure it was on William Dunn. There's no way it wasn't. No confusion this time.
You see Nero can really get to the basket. Going to the left and create, knocking down three shots.
He makes that free throw. It's been a while since he's made a field goal, but he's doing all of his damage from the charity stripe. There you take a look at the Memorial coaching staff for a moment. Coaching them up over there on the sideline. Reached the halfway mark of the third quarter. 45-28 is our score. Matthews with a three ball. Left it well short. Dunn trying to save that one from going out of bounds, but it was too far. Corey Guest back into the game for Memorial.
Many games you have today?
I've done this is my fourth. I have the next two as well. Ryan Wakely is actually going to join us.
All right.
Victory Christian head coach for the next two games, Adair and Owosso. All in all, out of the 24 games, I'll be on the call for 18. And I think it was late Sunday night. I started to feel a little tingle in my throat.
Oh, definitely.
And I was like, oh, this is not good. So I apologize for the raspy voice, the coughing every now and then. I'm trying to get this out of my head.
And hopefully,
hopefully it leaves before my voice does. I think that that's the battle going on right now.
Exactly. And, boy, it could definitely drain you. I remember doing the WAC tournament, and I think I did about 13, 14 college basketball games during the WAC tournament. And, boy, it was men's and women's, and, boy, it'll definitely drain you.
No, there's no doubt about that. I mean, you're talking about 15, 16-hour days, just nonstop basketball.
Yep.
You're having to be constantly aware of everything going on. I will say this. I'm going to sleep good on Friday night.
Oh, no doubt.
When this tournament's over. John Matthews.
Nice move.
Good basket that time from Will McDonald. And I shouldn't just make this about the whole OK Preps crew. We got camera people. We got our director. We got graphics. You know, our entire crew, they're going to be working a lot of hours over the next 3 days. So it's not just me putting in all the time. We got an entire crew here that's going to be working from sunup to sundown to bring you some great high school basketball here on OKPreps.com over the next 2.5 days. Caleb Nero, there's a collision with several players. No call. Letting them play. Kobe Rose with the triple knocks it down.
Rose able to get a good offensive series right there for Memorial.
That was his first basket here in the second half. Relatively quiet third quarter for Kobe Rose. 50-30 now. Memorial on top by 20. Been all Chargers since the early parts of the second quarter. Milton leaves that three ball short. Guest rebounds and gets it back to Nero.
If you're Heritage Hall, you can't settle for those shots there when you're trying to make a comeback. And Memorial getting high percentage shots like that.
Kobe Rose starting to feel it. He's got 15. Closing in on his season average of 16.8 points per game. Matthews working on Rose. We got a foul on Caleb. Or Kalen Childs, holding his left knee, limping off. Definitely didn't like something that happened there on that exchange. He's going to limp off. Guest and Isaiah Thomas also come off the floor. The Boone twins into the game. Shabar Walker also back into the game for Memorial. Heritage Hall went ahead and ran that play, but the only problem is they didn't have the ball to throw it in yet. Pass into Kanish, who we haven't really seen since the first quarter. Kobe Rose. And we have another player. There's Savon Milton. There you saw him at the bottom of your screen for a moment.
Yeah, they bang knees.
Kobe Rose going to shoot free throws, but before that happens, Heritage Hall wants a timeout with 1 minute and 20 seconds left here in the third quarter. Coming up next, we got another fantastic matchup. Well, what else is new here at the Tournament of Champions? Is the number one ranked team in Class 3A, the Adair Lady Warriors, will take on the Owosso Lady Rams, the number 8 team in Class 6A. Adair coming into this tournament undefeated on the year. Kenny Lippi will be playing on her future home floor as she has already signed her letter of intent with Oral Roberts University. And so Lippi, who has also had a 50-point performance already this season, looking forward to seeing her and Adair going up against a really strong squad in Owosso, where Owosso, you see the name Milton with Owosso, and you think of Shake.
Yep.
But we're talking about Taryn. Taryn Milton, Shake's younger sister. She had a quadruple-double earlier this season. So she's making it happen for the Owosso Lady Rams. Looking forward to seeing that matchup coming up next. It's scheduled for a 7 o'clock start. And we'll see. We'll see if that actually happens. Might be a little couple minutes after that.
Yeah, very talented player, but two good teams.
Kobe Rose, the lefty, from the free throw line. Gets it to fall. 16 points on the night. He ties Caleb Nero until now. Now he has 17 and sole possession of the game high. Savon Milton pump fakes the three. Now they're moving around. Pass nearly stolen. It's going to be Memorial ball.
Yeah, and that's the length you talk about on top of that zone. Kobe Rose is going to be, especially in high school, what you would consider a big guard. And able to get out and get the hand on the ball, cause deflections.
Caleb Nero crosses half court. Working on Les Thomas. Going to pull up from the top of the key. Can't get that one to fall. Matthews soars in there and grabs the rebound. Up ahead to Thomas.
Going to be a travel. Had to go up with that first one.
If he just would have gone straight up, he either would have gotten the basket or at least a foul call, because Caleb Boone was going over the back to stuff him, but he gets called for the travel. 40 seconds left here in the third quarter. 54-30. Nero floats one to Kobe Rose. Back to Nero. Pet tries to go out to Walker, but Milton, too quick, extends his hand, and he wants to take it all the way to the basket. He will not get the shot to fall, but he will go to the free throw line to shoot two.
Milton trying to get out and transition. That's a big difference. They haven't been able to get transition baskets like they're accustomed to doing.
They're going to say the foul was on the floor, so Heritage Hall with the basketball after the foul. Milton thought about the three. Now Thomas, now Matthews launches for three. In and out, no good. Rose with the rebound. Right before the buzzer. Oh, he almost hit it. Almost got that one to fall, but instead we reached the end of the third quarter. 54-30, Memorial leading Heritage Hall in a battle of the Chargers. Number 2 ranked team out of Class 5A, number 7 ranked team out of Class 4A. And if you're Heritage Hall, I wouldn't be too upset with this game, because look, Memorial, they're one of the best teams in the state regardless of class. Heritage Hall, they're in this tournament for one reason and one reason only, and that's for the competition. This is a team that has competed in Class 3A over the last 2 years, made it to back-to-back state championship games, but now they're dealing with Class 4A, and you're dealing with new monsters. You're dealing with Hera. You're dealing with Central, who we saw already today. You're dealing with teams like Ada and others. And so if you're Heritage Hall, I wouldn't be too upset about the outcome of this game. You just want the competition to get you ready for the rest of the season.
Yeah, and it really does. You know, I played in the Tournament of Champions, being from Beggs, and we were 3A at the time, and we thought it made a huge difference. I think the one thing you look at, of course, you go up a class or two classes, the higher the class, the more kids you select from, but the difference is you see the size. The size is what factors in. But Heritage Hall is going to be a very good team in that class, you know, across the board. This Memorial, too many weapons out there.
And we say it every single year here at this tournament. There's going to be a really, really good team that goes 0-3.
Yeah, no doubt.
That's just the way it is with the field that they have here, as Les Thomas goes up with it. Caitlin Childs comes down with it, but Les going to get free throws here. And I mean, you know, being a part of this tournament for the last 3 years with OKPreps.com, you know, we see some really good teams come into this tournament. They go 1-2, they go 0-3, they look like, you know, they can't buy a bucket, and then they go on and win a state championship. So it's all how you build on what happens during this 3-day stretch in Tulsa. Thomas misses the free throw. Misses both of them, and Walker beats the pressure. See if he goes all the way to the basket there. Blocked shot. And that was William Dunn. Curious as to why that was a foul call on him.
You see Walker doing a good job of breaking the press and
Shamar Walker misses the first. 7:29 left in the contest. Memorial, barring a monumental meltdown, and a monumental meltdown would be giving up a 25-point lead with 7 minutes left. Memorial going to move on to tomorrow to take on Edmond North, and that's going to be a fun matchup at 4 o'clock as Les Thomas makes the jumper. He's got 6. So you got Caleb Nero, you got Kobe Rose going up against Marvin Johnson and Marcus Wilson of Edmond North. We're going to have a fun matchup tomorrow afternoon, and we hope that you join us here on OKPreps.com as Isaiah Thomas gets the jumper.
That's going to be a nice matchup in that game.
The consolation game isn't going to be too shabby either. Heritage Hall going up against Fort Cobb Broxton. That's, you know, kind of make jokes in the third quarter about the length of this tournament and how many hours I'll be putting in, but that's the one thing that makes it all worth it, is it's all quality basketball. Even the seventh place games on Friday, you're going to have two pretty good teams.
Yeah, you're exactly right. A lot of talent on the floor. Very good players. As you said, somebody's going to leave 0-3, but there's a good chance that 0-3 team has a chance to win a state championship in their class. And that's what Thomas brings right there. You see him under the basket, able to make an athletic play. You see his athleticism and what he can do around the basket. That's why when you look at him and Shamar,
yeah,
Walker, they are X factors when you talk about this Memorial Charger team for Coach Bobby Allison.
And we mentioned in the first half, Isaiah Thomas, an Army All-American selection for football, and he's already committed to the University of Oklahoma. He'll be playing football for the Sooners. They're in action on Monday in the Sugar Bowl against Auburn. Isaiah, when his future team, the Sooners, are playing in New Orleans, Isaiah will be down in San Antonio getting ready for the Army All-American game. And he'll be one of several Oklahomans to be participating in the Army All-American game. Shawnee, offensive lineman Creed Humphrey, Collinsville linebacker Levi Draper, also named Army All-Americans. Shamar Walker up to Kobe Rose. Showtime here, perhaps. Throws it down with two hands.
Yeah, Rose gets up and finishes it home. Lefty, he can get up and finish it.
19 points for Kobe Rose. Leads all scorers with that 19. Thomas going to step back for three. Can't get it. Shamar Walker. What hustle. Colliding with Heritage Hall's Jaden McDaniel, younger brother of Tevin McDaniel, former Heritage Hall football star.
Yeah.
Now a freshman at the Air Force Academy.
And Mike McDaniel is a pretty good football player for the Sooners.
Yep. Tevin.
Fact, used to work here at ORU.
And not to mention you, Tevin, I spy him over there on the Heritage Hall bench, hanging out during the holiday break. Shamar Walker leaves the free throw short. While we're playing out the rest of this contest, 5:40, let's play a game as Matthews knocks down that three. Let's start with Heritage Hall. Give me a silver lining for Heritage Hall moving forward after watching the performance today. You know, what are some things that they can build on?
Well, I think the biggest thing that you see, I mean, as we talked about, glaring, they're not going to face anybody in their class with this kind of size. But going forward, you know, you have great guard play. When you talk about, you know, John and what he's able to do, but making a run and pushing in transition right now, the thing that you like is that they continue to compete. I've been watching this tournament a long time, and you see some teams that shuts down, just feels like they're outclassed. But going forward, you like the way they competed and the way they played hard. So you have to definitely build on that going forward as far as competing, playing, making the adjustments. And even in the second half, I think you look at the execution. They've gotten the ball to the middle of the high post more efficiently than they did in the first half. That's something you build on. That's something that when the coach say, hey, this is what we need to do, and you come out in the midst of getting beat pretty good, you come out and stick with it and execute. You haven't seen them go off and start doing their own deal. They're still trying to stick to the game plan. So I'm sure coach knows and will definitely build on this, but continue to play. You got great guard play. Maybe try to develop that inside presence some, but it's tough when you just don't have 6'6", 6'7", walking around, you know?
Yeah. Caleb Nero now with 17 points. All of his points here in the second half coming from the free throw line. Memorial leading Heritage Hall 63-39. And on the flip side for Memorial, look, it hasn't been all roses for them. What are some things that they need to improve on before tomorrow against Edmond North?
Well, I think a couple things they're going to have to do, you know, establish that inside presence and look for it. And you look at Childs right here, goes up and tries to finish. And definitely
that was nasty.
Able to go up and try to put that one down. But I think going forward, you know, they're going to have to be sure. I think a lot on the perimeter, you have a lot of dribbling right now. Tomorrow, you're not going to be able to dribble and keep the ball in your hand as much as you have tonight. You're going to have to beat the pressure with the pass. Edmond North is going to be a lot more rangy, longer athletes out there. So you'll kind of get in trouble. Going to be key to how the referees call the game. You know, I think that's going to be important. And also, you got to come out, and every single guy tomorrow night in this matchup is going to have to defend. They're going to have their best effort defensively on both ends of the court against that good team. Because when you look at Edmond North and you look at Memorial, they have two or three key guys. And what I mean by guys that's going on to play in college. So you look at, you know, Edmond North, you know, when you talk about Marvin Johnson, who's a big-time player going to play at the next level, and then you talk about Harrison Stoddard. You know, you can just kind of go down the line, and Marcus Wilson, of course, going to Lehigh. And when you think about that, that makes a huge difference defensively.
Yeah.
And I think Memorial is just going to have to really settle in. I don't know how much zone they can play tomorrow. I mean, probably play a lot more zone than man, but the defensive assignment and intensity is going to have to be at a different level against an Edmond North team.
65-41. As Nero converts on another free throw. What else is new? Definitely a good job by Caleb.
Yeah,
as he
knocking
now reaches
him down.
The 20-point mark.
And he works hard at it.
You know, one thing I'll say about this tournament, and I'm never going to knock, you know, guys like Gil Cloud, Tulsa Public Schools athletic director Mick Wilson, the tournament director, they do a phenomenal job putting the field together. But one thing I would have loved to see this year in the TOC, Trey Young and Norman North. That would have been fun.
Definitely. And you know, and I'm sure they tried to.
Oh, they probably
know,
did.
Get those teams. And, you know, you can only play so many tournaments. A lot of teams go out of state and play. Of course, you know, Norman North. You know, they went and played a tournament down in Texas. They also played up in Springfield. You know, they was in the field with Booker T up there. So, you know, probably just didn't line out, but definitely would have been good. But there's a good chance that he's still going to get to play on this ORU floor. Chance Norman North has a chance to be in the state tournament.
Just would have been fun.
Yeah, no
doubt.
That
was one of my Christmas wishes. It didn't come true. A lot of them did. A lot of them did. But that would have been fun to watch. Look, Trey Young is can't miss basketball at this point
in his career.
I think, you know, I haven't been able to, as Kobe Rose knocks down another, that's 21 now for Kobe. I haven't been able to get all the stats from Trey's games. No look pass from Matthews, but he wasn't ready for it. Rose is going to take it all the way, give him 23 now. I haven't been able to follow all of Trey's games so far this year, but I hear rumors that he's averaging borderline 50 points per game.
Yeah, I mean, just a weapon offensively. He can really get it going.
Mass subs coming into the game for Memorial on the next whistle, and that whistle just took place. So, Caleb Nero, Kalen Childs, Kobe Rose, Isaiah Thomas, and Shamar Walker will sit down for the final time with 2:45 left in the game. They'll get an early rest to get ready for tomorrow's semifinal against Edmond North. Into the game, Corey Guest back in, Caleb Boone. You also have Craig Webb into the game for the first time. Keelan Boone into the game, as well as Isaac Barker. Heritage Hall keeping their starters in for the time being. We'll see how long Chris Hamilton decides to do that. 72-44, Memorial leading Heritage Hall 72-44.
Nice, getting into the high post. Milton knocking it down.
Another jumper knocked down by Milton. Save on Milton.
One of the bright spots here is he has 23 points. Baseline jumper off the mark for Guest. Up ahead to Matthews. Matthews dishes it out to Les Thomas. Thomas crossing over Corey Guest. Ball goes out of bounds. They're going to call Corey for the blocking call. Corey Guest, the younger brother of Derek Guest, former Memorial Charger, was a part of last year's state runner-up team.
Yep, playing at Tonkawa now.
He's in the house tonight as well. Saw him earlier this evening. A lot of former Oklahoma standouts come out for the TOC, not just to support their school, but you see guys who go to other schools or went to other schools come out and just watch some great basketball, and that's the beauty of the Tournament of Champions, and we're happy to bring it to you on OKPreps.com. Memorial with a turnover. Here's Matthews attacking. Shot off the glass and in for Matthews. Cuts the lead to 22, but this one all but over. Memorial advancing to tomorrow. As Boone, Keelan Boone that time.
Boone and Boone.
Here's Thomas. Can't get the three. Gets his own miss. Here's Savon Milton. Left that three ball short. He's just running out of gas at this point. As Guest back the other way. Throws up a prayer. It's answered, but he's going to get whistled for the charge. Little out of control that time. Easy call for the official.
Yeah, officiating crew doing a good job here tonight. Clock still running.
And really, the officiating crew has done a great job today. And I know it's not just one crew. It's, you know, several different crews. But the officiating so far has been top-notch. New entries into the game for Heritage Hall. Want to get some of those names out before we play out the last minute and 12 seconds left. Michael McLaughlin into the game, as well as Jake LaForce. Also in is Ethan Kramer. Jaden McDaniel into the game. And Jack Griffin. Wanted to get all those names out for any of the parents that might be watching. Last thing I want to do is not say their baby's
oh,
name.
Oh, boy, you could get in big trouble.
Actually, the last thing I want to do is say their kid's name wrong.
No doubt about
that's
it.
That's the last thing. Michael McLaughlin knocks down the triple for Heritage Hall. But Memorial trying to respond with something of their own. And also into the game, this time for Memorial, is Micah Heron, senior forward, going to get called for the foul. Matavius Harris into the game for Memorial, as well as Bobby Allison completely empties his bench. Everybody on the roster going to play at least 30 seconds here tonight as more reserves come in. Julian Cockrell, younger brother of AJ. You can see it in his face too. He looks just like Big Brother. Shot off the back iron, no good. James Alexander also into the game. Under 30 seconds to go. Memorial with the ball. 74-53. We'll see if this is the final score or if the Charger reserves will get a bucket. Nope, they turned it over.
Yeah, probably won't get one now.
Heritage Hall. Here's the three ball left short. Rebound by Memorial. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1, And the Memorial Chargers are going to advance to the semifinals after winning this one 74-53. Coach, before we let you go, just final thoughts on this win for the Memorial Chargers.
I think, like we said going in, the size advantage was a big difference. I thought Memorial really got going in that second quarter. But just kind of too many weapons for, you know, this Heritage Hall team, and they'll advance on to play, you know, Edmond North. But the size, the athleticism, and the strength, you know, Kobe Rose and Caleb Nero, outstanding games. The inside presence of Thomas made a huge difference in this matchup. Thus, they walk away with the win.
Memorial knocks off Heritage Hall 74-53. We got the final stats here, and we're going to be joined momentarily by Memorial head coach Bobby Allison. He'll join us over at the broadcast booth. But before he does, let's give you the numbers for Heritage Hall, who drops to 2-2 on the season. It's officially a losing streak, although I don't think that's going to last very long. They are 2-2 on the year. They shot 34% from the field. They were led by Savon Milton, who finished with 23 points. You also had John Matthews chipping in with 12, Les Thomas with 11. From Memorial, they shot 60% from the field. You had Caleb Nero with 20, Kobe Rose led all scorers with 23. Isaiah Thomas, we talked about him a lot, 14 points, 8 rebounds. And Kalen Childs finished with 10 points in the win from Memorial as they win it 74-53. My thanks goes out to Rod Thompson for joining us here this evening, and we're now being joined by Memorial head coach Bobby Allison as the Chargers win the battle of the Chargers. It goes to Memorial 74-53. Coach, the first quarter was sloppy. After that, you guys took care of business.
Yeah, both teams got a lot of pride, and both teams have been in big games. You know, their three guards started in the state championship game, so it's kind of like feeling your opponent out like a boxing match that first round. Yeah. Nobody really – you know, got their flow going, and we offensive rebounded good in that second quarter, which led to some layups, and then Nero and Kobe got going, and that's that first quarter, which is what you expect in a bigger arena with, you know, two quality teams. And that second quarter, we really rebounded well, both ends, and then we made shots.
The difference for me, and really the stats pointed out as well, you outscore Heritage Hall 34-10 in the paint. A lot of that due to Kalen Childs as well as Isaiah Thomas.
Yeah, they're pretty big, strong kids. And, you know, and tomorrow night they're going to go against a group that's just as big and just as strong as them. But tonight we definitely – I said that before the game to the kids. I said if you match their guards up versus our guards 3-on-3, be a pretty good game. But – I said 4 and 5s, I think we'd win in a 2-on-2 game with our 4s versus their 5s every single time. Just, I mean, they got sophomores down there at the 4 and the 5, and we got 2 18-year-old college athletes, seniors. So we definitely got an advantage down there tonight, and they took advantage of it.
You face Edmond North tomorrow in the semifinals. Mm-hmm. First thoughts on that matchup?
No, it's going to be fun. It's a great opportunity for us. You know, it's not going against a 6A opponent like that. It's perfect. It's perfect. Exactly what we need on this stage tomorrow night for our seniors. It's an opportunity that they've worked for. We haven't even mentioned them, even though I know it's been in the back of their head that, you know, Edmond North was out there, Midwest City and Union, three teams that are arguably the three best teams in the state.
Yep.
And our seniors, you know, they wouldn't have it any other way than to have 1, 2, and 3 and 6A as possible. I mean, we're going to play – 2 of the top 3 in 6A the next two nights. It's just a matter of what side of the bracket we're going to play them on. So,
well, Tahlequah-Sequoia could pull the upset.
And I should not speak on that, because Tahlequah-Sequoia beat them 10 years ago. And that's, we played Tahlequah-Sequoia last year, and that was a bad move on my part. You never know. You're exactly right.
Well, Coach.
Bad move.
Coach, good luck tomorrow against Edmond North. We'll see you tomorrow in the semifinals.
Definitely. Thanks, Mike.
That's Bobby Allison, head coach of the Memorial Chargers. His Chargers win it 74-53. We'll be back with game number 7 momentarily. I'm Michael Knight. My thanks again to Rod Thompson, who joined us. We're going to be joined by Ryan Wakely, the head coach at Victory Christian, coming up next. And we'll have some girls basketball, our last girls game of the evening, as 3A's number 1 8-Air will face off against 6A's number 8 Owosso. That's coming up next right here on OKPreps.com.